Sensitivity is not a weakness. Sensitivity is actually a strength, and it needs to be embraced. It really does. I want to share with you a story from when I was in the corporate world. This was before I got cancer. I was working in this company, and at that time, so this is after my engagement had broken up, and I told my parents that I'm going to find my own husband and so on. And of course, when I married Danny, he was, he was like, you're a free person, do whatever you want. And so anyway, I had this fabulous career, which to me was my dream job. And it was my dream job because I used to sell handbags, purses. And I'm a bit of a shopaholic, and I love purses. So I worked for this handbag company, or this company that created handbags, purses, and other fashion accessories. And we were a wholesale company. So we used to sell our products to retailers. And so the company I was with, we were wholesale, we were a manufacturing company, basically. So the company manufactured these fashion accessories, and we sold it on to retailers. And I had this wonderful boss who was male, but he was a really great guy, and he was the one that had kind of helped me to rise through the ranks of the company. And I had a great managerial job where I had a wonderful number of clients who were retailers who all trusted me. They trusted my judgment, and they would literally buy from me every season, like practically blindly. They just trusted me if I would say, this is the line you have to buy, this is what you have to buy. And I never abused that trust, which is why they trusted me. They knew that whatever I told them to buy, it would literally walk off the shelves. So they were happy, they made money with everything. And these clients, I became so close to them because they trusted me, and I knew they wouldn't take their business anywhere else. I had that kind of trust in them. And they would take me out for meals every now and then. So I had this trust, and it was a really good number of clients. And so I was happy, they were happy, my boss was happy. One day what happened is that we had a corporate head office, which was based in France because it was a French company. And in this corporate head office, decided to get rid of my boss and put in place, and in his place, the person who came in his place was somebody who I believe demanded a much higher salary from my company, from the corporate head office. In order to justify his salary, he was an extremely sharp businessman who had negotiated a huge package for himself. A huge package with salary and bonuses and other benefits. But in order to justify his salary, he had to increase the sales of this company. And so to do that, he started to put a lot of pressure on me to increase the sales. And as he was putting all this pressure on me, he just kept pushing me, and he kept trying to get me to even sell dead stock to my clients. And I said, I can't do that. I just can't do that. And he was like, why not? And then he said, you need to work harder. He kept raising my targets. And then he took it actually a little too far, where he started to make me feel that I couldn't do what I was supposed to do because I was a woman. Because he started to make little stabs at the fact that I wanted to go and be with my husband. I wanted to go home. I had a family life. And he started to say that, you're so distracted because you're married. I want somebody in this office who can come in on weekends. Now, I'd never needed to do that before. So eventually he started to bully me and set me up to fail. And I was so miserable that I quit. I left. Now, I know that even the feelings that he the relationship I had with him contributed to my already very low self-esteem. It contributed to even that whole downhill climb into getting cancer. However, many, many months, maybe it was a year or two later, I found out from ex-colleagues who knew me that after I left, because he had thought, all these clients are just buying blind, the stuff is walking off the shelves, why does he need me? Why does he need me? Because the products are selling themselves. I discovered that after he fired me, he lost all my clients. He lost all the clients because they were buying from me because they trusted me, the person, because I had built a relationship with them. They did not have a relationship with him, and they didn't like his style, so they went somewhere else, and he got fired. And so this is why, and why am I telling you this? Because this is where people need to recognize that sensitivity is the new strong. Sensitivity has its place. Sensitivity, if it's not there, if we all just become people who are uncaring, we don't, then what it actually reduces from this business world. Once we start realizing that we as women actually add and contribute to it, we have a very, very different type of environment. We have a different kind of corporate environment and a corporate culture. But the thing is, one of the highlights to that story was a few years later, of course I had cancer, the cancer died, the book came out, and for those of you who don't know, Wayne Dyer, you know who Wayne Dyer is, right? Yeah, so he discovered my story on the internet. He's the one that contacted his publisher, Hay House, told them that they must publish contact me and get me to write a story and publish my story. After the book came out, and Wayne Dyer had me on TV, and my book hit the New York Times bestseller list and so on. After all that happened, one day I bumped into that old boss on the street. Years had passed, and I bumped into him on the street, and he looked really awkward. And he actually came up to me. I didn't know he would come up to me. I just kind of acknowledged him. He came right up to me and he said, "Oh, it's so nice to see you. I just want you to know that everything that happened all those years ago, it wasn't personal. It was just something I had to do for the, it was work related. It was to do with the corporate culture." And from him, that was as good as an apology. But the thing is, it was interesting for me because it was like a healing for me that, okay, that whole chapter is closed. And so it was just a very interesting thing for me to experience that. Although I'm not really interested in taking revenge or anything, but it was just an interesting thing to feel that I didn't need to do anything. The universe has its own way of doing it.